Luke 8:41. If I invade your man already. In this text, the gospel according to Luke, Jesus says in verse 46, somebody touched me. For I thought the virtue go out of me. Never mind this. I got 5 minutes. What do you think, preacher? Jesus says, somebody pull some power out.
Yes, sir.
I can stop in the park right there. The problem with us, the Latter-day Saint, you saw busy waiting on him to give it to you.
Desperate touch.
Yes. See, come on in front of you. And it was a desperate touch. This is why I'm stopping and pausing and asking, who touched me? I want to know who this is. Now, y'all know Jesus knew who it was. He's God in the flesh. He already knew who it was. He didn't want to see if she's going to come forth. See, here's one of the biggest issues with us. We get a healing from God. And they go all about our business like looking at God wants you to come forth and let folk know that, hey, I got healed. Watch this. So, this desperate person pulls power out of Christ. Let me give it a text. Watch this. Verse 43 says, and a woman having an issue of blood for 12 years was spent on her living upon physicians, but neither could be healed, came up behind him, touched the border of his arm, and immediately saved him. They were not permitted to speak in public. They were to cover themselves at all times. They couldn't pick who they wanted. They had to be introduced into marriage or given away. They had no rights, meaning that Yamaha, y'all talk to us today, you couldn't do that. And if you had an issue, meaning any type of sickness, you were treated like a fifth class citizen. Because the biggest thing that you had in biblical days was your hair and the fact that you could make men children, period. Anything outside of that, you were kind of treated like a slave. I'm just being honest. You couldn't defend yourself in a woman form. And if you had any type of disease, man or female, you had or was declared what they call a running issue, meaning that you had to live on the outskirts of town and you were declared unclean unless your issue cleared up, and the priests were having to be the ones to inspect you and tell you that you were clean. So here's a woman that's been bleeding and stinking for 12 years. Desperate. Heard that Jesus was passing through. Desperate. I'm broke, stinking, don't have a friend. I'm taking the risk of getting stolen because if I go up here, they grab me.
Of the hem of the garment, the reason she They open up the door and just run to the house. Then you run to another house. Now you run through about three or four houses, you confuse the cops. Ah, one more got courage in this way. What I'm saying is this. Listen to me. You are desperately trying to get healed. This woman is saying, look, I don't care what they say. I don't care what they're doing. I don't care who sees it. My situation has gotten so bad that I'm willing to run for his board. I'm desperately running. What I got to lose? I'm broke.
Being proper. My dear, what would you have, God?
do.
She said, sir, you don't understand. I am desperate. I'm desperate for it. And I want to be real with God. And y'all are weird. You know how y'all look at me? That's how I look at me. The preacher standing up there. He ready to pray for her. She said, no, I got to get real with him. Y'all know what she did? She stashed her wig on the room floor. Popped her mask off. Started removing stuff. Popped her nail. So the preacher's looking at her. Why are you doing all this? Because I've been faking. I've been faking with God all the time. But when she snatched that wig off, my whole church went nuts. It looked crazy, but it was sincere. Because she was saying, look, if I'm that desperate and I want to be that sincere with God, I don't want nothing from I'm trying to get as close to him as I can and get away as far away from that phone as I can. I feel the Holy Spirit. See, there comes a time when you gotta get naked before God. And you can't give a darn about who's seeing, what's going on, when it's happening. See, you see, your breakthrough is predicated on your sincerity. It's not predicated on how cheap you can be before God. It's how desperately ugly you're going to be.
Thank you.
just because one hasn't gone through as much hell as the other.